Come on in, come on up, come on over for the merriest time of year.
Hello and welcome to the rest of our European adventure. So today's the day we leave for Berlin. I am all ready to go to the airport. Derek is packing the car. And holy crap, has it been a day already? It is noon-ish. It's a little afternoon. And so at like 9:05, we get an email from United that is like, we've been trying to contact you about your flight. So cue anxiety. Our flight from Frankfurt to Berlin was canceled, and the only other flight that had seats on it was at 9 p.m. tomorrow evening, which is not going to work for us for obvious reasons, but also we have a reservation at the TV tower for dinner, and that was a prepaid reservation for 4 o'clock. So after probably an hour on the phone with United, we finally rebooked through Munich. We were flying from Dulles to Munich now, and then we have a 5-hour layover in Munich, which will get us to Berlin at 2 p.m., which is the best that they could do. They couldn't fly us through another city. They couldn't fly us anywhere else. They had to fly us through Germany. So we're going to make it, hopefully, but just stress, anxiety. But we are booked all the way through. We don't have to find a train from Frankfurt to Berlin. We don't have to do any of that stuff. But then in Munich, there is no lounge. So that sucks, but at least we're getting there. But it's been stressful already and we haven't even left yet. Our flight is at 5:20 tonight. So we are getting ready to head out, drop Charlotte off at the dog sitter and be on our merry way. We've made it to Munich. We did not sleep on that flight. The extra legroom seats were taken away from us when we changed our flight, so we didn't get any sleep. United regular economy seats are terrible. They're just like so uncomfortable. But here we are. We're in the the priority pass lounge, the Munich airport, so we got something to eat. And I literally just woke up from a 20-minute nap. But we're in Germany and we are making our way to Berlin. Our next flight is in like 2 hours or something like that. So we will be boarding that flight shortly and making our way to Berlin.
The Berlin Marathon Expo took place at the Tempelhof Airport, which was originally built in the 1920s by the Nazi government of Germany. Later, it was used as a way to get supplies in and out of Berlin by the Allied forces. Now, it is a beautiful, old, historic building. The runway and the green space around the runway are still intact and utilized as a park for the people of Berlin to enjoy. The building remains a time capsule where all of the ornate details are still intact. The park is used for many different activities, and there is a small Ukrainian refugee camp in the park where the people who have fled from the Ukrainian-Russian war are currently living.
Hello, and welcome to the rest of our European adventure. You may ask why I'm sitting on the floor. Pro tip, if you are booking a train in Germany and they ask you if you want to book a seat, you should probably do it because we are sitting on the floor. Currently, Natalie is over there. Derek is right in front of me. And every 30 minutes, we have to get up, either one side or the other, so people can get on the train. My feet hurt, my knees hurt, and it is not fun standing up and sitting down. Even though I only ran 13.1 miles, I'm still feeling it. So, woohoo! We're on our way to Munich, and we will be there in 3 hours. So, just have to endure the floor for 3 hours.
If you are ever in Munich during Oktoberfest, I highly recommend taking a ride on the Ferris wheel, especially at night when all of the lights are on. It's a beautiful 360 view of the entire park where Oktoberfest happens. It is a little pricey at 10 euro, but it is 150% worth it. There are definitely some WTF rides at Oktoberfest. This one was our favorite facade. And as you can see, it only got better. This was the ride vehicle for that ride.
Whoa, another, whoa! All right. Oh, okay. Oh, 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 oh.
Jigsaw was at home. Whoa!
Bye-bye, Oktoberfest! It was so much fun. We had a great time. But now it is time to move on to Paris.
You.
We are currently sitting in the airport in Munich, ready to board our flight to Paris. And not gonna lie, our travel days have been just a bear. We have TSA pre-check at home, so going through the security line today was kind of a shock. Even though we didn't have to take off our shoes, we still had to like remove all of our electronics. I have my two computers, my work computer and my personal computer, and then we have the GoPro and the Osmo Pocket and just like a lot of stuff. So it was a little bit of a nightmare. Also, apparently here for Lufthansa, you can check your bag electronically, like you can go to a self-service kiosk if your bag is under 7 kilos. If it's over 7 kilos, it like has to, you have to stand in line and you have to check it with an agent, which doesn't make any sense because our bags were free anyway. So I don't really understand what that was about, but we are at the gate. So far the flight is on time. We are not holding our breath because because last time we were here and on Lufthansa, we were delayed an hour. So we will see what happens. But we are on to Paris and on to Disneyland. They've got Halloween at Disneyland Paris! I'm so excited! Here we are! Look! There she is! Ah!
Dreams. Alors aujourd'hui, que diriez-vous de rêver plus loin, de sourire plus grand et de rire plus fort? So now, we invite you to dream bigger, smile wider, and laugh louder. Together, let's make the future brighter than ever. Ensemble, rendons l'avenir plus brillant que jamais. La magie ne fait que commencer. The magic. It's just begun.
Welcome to Disneyland Paris. We are inside of Skull Rock right now. We have been on three rides so far. Four rides so far. Hyperspace Mountain, Snow White, Pinocchio, and Indiana Jones. All fantastic. All said 5 minute waits, but they are not 5 minutes. You would need to add like 10 minutes to anything that the sign says because we got in line thinking that we were gonna wait 5 minutes and we waited about 15. So it's still not too bad, but the lines are not accurate, or the wait times are not accurate. So, c'est la vie, right? We're in France, we are at Disneyland Paris, and we're having a great time. We're about to go get brunch, Captain Jack's restaurant. So it's right at Pirates of the Caribbean, so we get to watch the boats go by.
Les places disponibles. On n'a plus beaucoup de temps. Analyse d'état de l'eau escamotable.
Toy Story Land and Disneyland Paris. Here we are. Oh, look, it's Slinky Dog. This is where we're going, the RC coaster. Following the tracks to the RC racer. That claw, the claw.
Thank you. We are chilling in the France Pavilion right now, and we are right over next to Ratatouille. We just went on it, and my take home is that it is almost exactly the same as the one at Epcot, except for a little bit more French and a lot less wait. The wait time was 15 minutes, but we have the premier access, so we waited maybe 5 minutes. But I've got my glass of French champagne, and we're just chilling. They have cute little food and wine style booths here, so we're trying a little bit of the food here as our dinner and drinking a little bit of wine.
Admirer les portraits de la sublime maîtresse des lieux et de ses prétendants moins chanceux. Perhaps you sense a disquieting metamorphosis. Hélas, les choses ne sont pas toujours ce qu'elles paraissent. Tous les contes n'ont pas de fin heureuse. It appears everyone is doomed at Phantom Manor. Even you? And notice this. This chamber has no windows and no doors, which offers you this chilling challenge to find a way out.
Made it to Paris proper, and the first stop is Notre Dame. It's got all the walls around it now because, as y'all probably know, it burned not too long ago, so they are repairing it now. But video doesn't do it justice. It is beautiful, absolutely gorgeous. We are at the Louvre. We're not sure if we're gonna go in or not. We're trying to figure that out. But here we are. It's gorgeous. Look at that advertisement. Beautiful. Chef's kiss. Here is the beautiful Champs-Élysées. I am American and cannot pronounce French words, apparently. The Arc de Triomphe is all right there. And I don't know if we're going there or not, because my knee hurts. We made it to the Arc de Triomphe. Here we are. We're talking about going up there, but we're not quite sure how to get there. We are making it down the road to the Eiffel Tower. We're just wandering around Paris today, seeing what we can see. These buildings are gorgeous. Look at them. They're so beautiful. Oh man. Gonna make our way over to the Eiffel Tower. And that's really the last thing that we had on our must-do list. So then afterwards we will have almost the entire afternoon, early evening, to do whatever it is that we decide to do. We made it to the Eiffel Tower. Look at her, she's a beaut. Look at all the people. It's insane. I feel like I'm at Disneyland Paris all over again. So many people. But she's worth it. So here we are at the Eiffel Tower. You cannot even get under it without a ticket. But the most disappointing part is that I just assumed that this was gonna all be grass, but it's just nasty dirt and water. This grossness because of all the people who walk on it. But if you see any movies, there's grass here, and now there isn't. But I am thankful that we got to come and see the Eiffel Tower, even if we're not gonna pay 28 euro to go up because the line is insane. Okay, so now I feel like maybe we're at the place that I think about when I think of movies in Paris of the Eiffel Tower, because there's some grass here. Some. We found a store that is full of quote unquote American stuff. So of course we had to go in and buy a Chupa Chups strawberry and cream flavored sparkling water, soda, I'm not sure which, but we're gonna try it. I've never seen this in America, but hey, when in Paris, try something quote unquote American. Okay folks, you are getting the real, raw, first impression of the Chupa Chups soda, or whatever this is, sparkling water, I don't know. Ready? It actually smells like a strawberry and cream Chupa Chups. I wish they had this chocolate one because that's my favorite of the actual lollipops, but this one's my second favorite, so we'll go with it. Oh my god, it tastes exactly like the lollipop, except in drink form. It's awesome. So we found a little cafe on a cute little market street in Paris. I'm having a champagne and Derek is having a beer. He went to go get us a French pastry. And we're having just a lovely afternoon in Paris. We are at dinner, and this is our last meal. Well, our last dinner in Paris. We got the raclette cheese, some potatoes, and an assortment of ham. Super, super excited. Look at this. I've never seen anything like this. It's amazing. We know the time is short.